Welcome to another episode of the VA Showcase on BCTV, our monthly show devoted to information relative to military veterans and their families. I'm your host, Ken Lebron. I am the director of the Berks County Veterans Affairs Office, also known as the Etchberger Veterans Service Center of Berks County. Our office is located at 726 Cherry Street in Reading. Our show today will focus on the interview of our new Education and Benefits Outreach Specialist, Stephen Mannino. Steve, thank you so much for being with us today. We are so excited to have you on our team. Please tell us a little bit about yourself. Where have you been? What have you done? And how did you find your way to us at the Berks County Veterans Affairs Office?
Thank you. Thank you, Ken. I guess it started out when many years ago in the 80s when I wasn't sure where my future path would be. And I had some help from family members to say, why don't you try the military because you don't have nothing else to lose. And that's what I did. I joined the Air Force with the understanding that another couple of family members were in. And so I enlisted. Wasn't sure what I was going to do, so I let them pick, and they decided to enlist me as a life support survival specialist. And that's where I started in 1984 down in South Carolina, a small town called Sumter. And it was an experience from a northern guy that wasn't too familiar with the South, but I started out there. I ended up marrying my wife, and we moved down to Sumter, South Carolina, at Shaw Air Force Base. We stayed there for 5 years. I worked with the F-16 aircraft, learned a lot about the life support, the equipment there. I actually also went to a lot of survival schools. Mm-hmm. And the survival schools were like the combat, water, Antarctic, actually. So I got the real taste of what it means to be out in the woods and be living on the land. So these are some things that I'll never forget. And then from there, we decided to move back up to Pennsylvania, and I went into the National Guard, first one being at the Willow Grove Naval Air Station, where I worked on the A-10 aircraft. And then I moved up into the ranks of non-commissioned officer in charge and then a superintendent. And from there, I decided to move a little bit closer west, and I went to Harrisburg working on the C-130 aircraft. So I had a wide variety of aircraft experience and personnel, and I've been all over the world. I've been all over the country. You name it, I've been there. I've been in support of many of the conflicts, from Persian Gulf to the Enduring Freedom to Iraqi Freedom. I've probably deployed maybe 7 or 8 times within the different units that I was with. So I got a real understanding of what it means to be a military member and a veteran. And it was humbling, very humbling on what we could do for others. Some of the highlights of my career was when I was able to successfully train a individual air crew to eject out of an aircraft safely, come back, and tell me that, hey, you just saved my life. That was like a highlight, that, you know, the worth that you do. And other times it was not so great when they didn't make it, and I had to deal with, well, was there something that we did or not do? And it's kind of tough. But all in all, the military career that I had was, I wouldn't have given up for for anything. The experience, the people that I was with, and just getting to see the world. So then there was a time where after 33 years, I'm ready to hang it up, and that's what I did. And roughly 2017, I retired. I got my 20-year retirement, and then I thought I would take off, enjoy life, travel a little bit, fix up my house, but then I started getting bored. I started thinking, well, there's something else I can do. And that's when I had the opportunity to work with the census. Part of the 2020 census, you had a time where, you know, every 10 years you get to do this. We went through and we went to all over Berks County and Schuylkill and Chester and just talked to people, and I enjoyed that. I found a new love that I never thought existed. And once I did that, I got involved with the different organizations to support the census and so forth. And one being the Berks County Veterans Affairs Office. And Ken invited me in. I went to a couple of their, they have a crosstalk meeting every second Wednesday of the month. And I joined there, and for some reason or not, they saw something in me that maybe I could help out. And that's where it ended up being, where as the census period was dying down and closing, they reached out to me and asked me if I would be interested. And I'm like, sure, because the best thing that I could have done after retirement is to get out and help other people out. And what better to do with helping the veterans? And the rest is pretty much where I'm at now, and learning every day of what this journey is about, is all about.
Absolutely. Absolutely, Steve. So as you had mentioned, we noticed that urge or that desire in you to be able to give back and to help other veterans and their dependents and family members and caregivers in need, given your extensive military career, your experience over 33 years with the military, and your civilian experience as well. We knew that you would be a good fit for not only the office, but also for the responsibility of reaching out to informing individuals regarding the benefits that they may be entitled to with the VA. And it was also really, really good experience for you to work through our office as a claimant as well. As a veteran who was seeking benefits from the VA, who we were able to assist with applying for VA benefits, working through that system kind of gave you an idea as to what is this all about, right? So fill us in a little bit more on your current role and responsibilities with us at the office as the Education and Benefits Outreach Coordinator. What are some of the things that you get to do?
A lot, and much more to come. It's when I first started here, of course, we had the unfortunately the COVID, the pandemic, which allowed us not to get out, not to reach the people. So, in some ways, it gave me an opportunity to really hone in on the education of what the VA benefits and opportunities were about. I never realized all the different opportunity, all the different benefits that the veterans can receive. That gave me some opportunities to learn more about that. And then as time went on, and as we slowly branched out to different levels of getting out into the public, I started doing that. I started getting more confidence in it and with reaching out. And I just loved talking on the phones. And you may talk to an individual that is 90 years old and just looking for some help, or just looking to talk, you know, to someone and another fellow vet. And it was so neat on that. And every phone call I get, every briefing that I get more experience. But what my roles, from what I gathered, was awareness, making veterans aware of the different benefits and opportunities that they have. And just like me, I was unaware of all these, and I'm like, well, I can speak the talk. I can talk the talk. I can go out and say, well, I've been there. And when you talk to someone like that says, hey, I've been there, they kind of hone in and think, okay, maybe you're right. You know, maybe you're talking what we need to hear. And so I go out, some things I know, I've learned this for a fact also, that I don't know everything. And I know there's certain things that I have to pass off on the specialists that we have in our office. We have veteran service officers, they call them VSOs, and they're the ones that the experts along with Ken, to get the individual in, to get them the claim and the benefits that they deserve as a veteran. They, some of the veterans are reluctant because of how the VA may have treated them. It's my job to just kind of smooth that out and say, why don't you give it another try? You know, so that's some of the roles in coordination that we do. I'll go to benefits presentations. I go to different events throughout the year that I've been already, and it's still growing and growing as I go. And each time I do that, it's more, I meet more people, and not just veterans, but other organizations that I can get to know. And when a veteran's calling and saying, hey, I need help building a ramp for their house, mm-hmm. I can jump in there and say, well, I know this person. He's a, he or she has this place and they're willing to help out for free. I also am working on like a pool of volunteers. And there's so many veterans out there that love to volunteer. And so I get involved in that and get that database, that group together in case for some reason we need to have a veteran for a transportation ride to a medical appointment. Things like that.
I'm so glad that you mentioned that, Steve, because we have a tall order here in Berks County with just over 23,000 veterans residing in Berks County. We have a large mission and we do so much more than just claims. As you had mentioned, you know, we get all sorts of calls at our office and we try to help and to assist as best as we can. If we can't, we can make the appropriate referral or identify resources, programs or benefits for them within the community. But, you know, you're absolutely right. It is important for us to do the best that we can to inform our veterans and their family members and their dependents about what benefits are out there, what's available for them. You know, you answered the next question that I had is why is it so important for us to conduct outreach? I mean, still till this day, we will have individuals maybe coming into our office or calling us saying, hey, I didn't know you were located here in the city of Reading. I didn't know this is what you did. I didn't know you could help us this way. Now, as County Veteran Service Officers credentialed under the state of Pennsylvania, under the Pennsylvania Department of Military and Veterans Affairs, we certainly don't know it all either. But our job is to identify the information if we don't know it. We utilize federal law, Title 38, Code of Federal Regulations, the United States Code, to identify laws pertaining to access for veterans when it comes to these benefits. The benefits are at the federal, the state, and at the local levels. So Steve, as you mentioned, there's a lot of different benefits out there, a lot of eligibility criteria for the veterans or for their dependents. And our job is to identify what benefit may they qualify for, identify the appropriate documentation, and send that documentation fully developed and or completed into that adjudicating authority to make that final decision. And when I say final decision, a decision from the federal VA, the state VA, or even from the local county government VA is not a final decision. If there is an issue with regard to maybe a decision that's incorrectly rendered, there's always an option for a veteran or an applicant to appeal that decision. And that's important to mention as well. So Steve, there's a lot of information out there. There's a lot of benefits. There's a lot of resources. Sometimes it can be overwhelming and we get individuals say, thank you so much for being our assistant, for being our guiding help, for being our advocate. What are some of those benefits or resources out there for not only veterans, not only their family members or caregivers, but maybe anyone who's interested in trying to assist a veteran or point them in the right direction or to let them know, hey, there's this resource available for you to learn more about what the VA may have to offer you? What are some of those resources?
Well, the first one, and this is something I've been doing, and I try to promote at each phone call or each event, is that I go into Tuesday, afternoons at 1:30, we have a benefits presentation. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be a veteran. It could be a caregiver. It could be a spouse. It could be a widow. It could be any of them. Mm-hmm. We do that, and it's pretty much in our office. We have a PowerPoint demonstration. Now, for some reason, if you can't get to that presentation, we have a website called the County of Berks VA. If you go on that, and it's the Etchberger Veterans Service Center website, okay? If you go on that website, look down on the right-hand side, there's a benefits presentation. You could sit at your home if you can't get transportation to our office, and you can watch that presentation. There's also the... and by the way, you don't have to reserve, there's no RSVP for this benefits presentation. So just please come in, show up 1:30, and we're there to help you. There's also the www.va.gov. That is an awesome resource that it helped me as I was getting ready to retire, and I was looking at different types of information as far as benefits and so forth like that. The VA also changed their hotline. It's 1-800-MY-VA-411. You can kind of decipher that as far as the actual digits or the numbers. And that's also, when you call in, there's going to be a series of prompts. So if there's something with disability, something with life insurance, health care, you name it, it just follow the prompts, and when that prompt hits, click that, and they're going to be connecting with you. There's also our monthly crosstalk. We have, I mentioned that before, we have a second Wednesday of every month at 10 o'clock. Now, right now, we're doing it virtual, and may change in the future, but that's a great way. Anyone could get on that and just call our office if need be to get a link to go on that. And finally, there's social media. We do have for those that are able to navigate through that, there's a Facebook page that is just dedicated for the VA, for the Berks County VA. There's also a LinkedIn account that we have that's set out. So a lot of, from folks that are seniors down to the folks that are technical savvies that can navigate through the computer, we're here for you, and we're there to get that word out.
How about that, you know, when COVID really, really kicked off and we weren't really going anywhere, which I wanted to also elaborate on. It was great to give you that time in the office to really get your feet under you so that you can kind of hit the ground running before you really made it out into the community with regard to outreach events. There was a resource that we implemented and created, and it's on our website, and it is a presentation about 40, 50 minutes long. Mm-hmm. Somebody can watch that presentation from the comfort of their own home, in the safety of their own home, and as their time allows. So we do have that pre-recorded benefits presentation for anyone to watch on our website as well. Steve, really quickly, you touched on it a little bit, but let's talk a little bit about some of the common misconceptions or arguments that veterans might present to you as you're encouraging them to apply for VA benefits. What are some of the things that really kind of shock you that they say to almost avoid the process of applying for benefits they may be entitled to?
Some of them were, they just don't think that they're kind of just coming to a conclusion without even trying. Mm-hmm. And with the VA and with what I've noticed in the past and the present actually now, mm-hmm. is that things change. So if a veteran has some kind of symptoms and he tried to go in for a claim and it got denied, well, that situation may change over the years. Mm-hmm. Agent Orange, Blue Water, some of these different conditions change as they find out that there's new information and evidence that, yes, you were involved in that. There is a burn pit registry now. Mm-hmm. Some of these things, and sometimes the veteran does not feel that they're going to have any success doing it, mm-hmm. or they just don't care.
Yeah, or they're not deserving of it, mm-hmm. or they haven't earned it, or they'll say things like, well, I figured since I've got all of my limbs that I am not entitled to or eligible for benefits from the VA. Or, you know, I'll leave it to individuals who are more deserving of the benefit. But they are deserving of it. When they served in the military, when they put on that uniform, you know, when they took risks that many don't take, who haven't served in the military, they are entitled to benefits from the VA. And we want our veterans and the community to be aware of that. You don't have to have physical injuries, you know, to apply or to qualify for certain VA benefits. So that's important for us to mention. You'd mentioned opportunities for community members to get involved with us and to volunteer with us. You're our point of contact at the office. We call them veteran ambassadors, and they're individuals who feel like they want to give back in one way or another. Or we have helped them so extensively or tremendously, or they're so happy with the service that they've received from our office, they'll often say, Ken, I would love to get involved. So you're working on building groups or teams of volunteers for certain volunteer initiatives. What are some examples of some of those volunteer initiatives that we might call veterans to for support with?
There's several, and really the way to get the start was when I mentioned about the Berks County VA website. On the right-hand side, there's a, it's like an intake form. And you click on that, and it's going to give you this, I'm not going to show this up, but it's like a form that you can get involved. And so say you have different attributes throughout your career within the military or others, and you have writing skills, you have speaking skills, you have you just want to do some transportation. You write all that down, and that helps us form a pool. Then we go out, and some of these, you just never know. It could be assisting a veteran to a medical appointment. It could be, we had last year, or maybe it was in, no, it was in the spring of this year, we had a gentleman who was pretty much homeless, and we went out and helped him redo his house. It could be that type of thing. We had volunteers to go out and just sit at a table and give out information for the public during different events. So there's a multitude of different ways that we can go out and have them get involved, and they love it. We also have folks that can sit on a committee board for the Berks County Hall of Fame that we do every year, and they get involved in that, and it gives them something to do because retirement can be tough for some folks. They get stagnant, and they just don't feel worthy. And for them to get out and volunteer, I could see it in their faces. We do the flag presentations. We put flags on all the cemeteries throughout the Berks County areas. All those things. They take a lot of people that are willing to step up and do these jobs, and we're forever grateful for them.
Absolutely. So just to reiterate, there is a link on the right side of our webpage. The verbiage specifically will say something to the effect of request an appointment or volunteer intake sheet, and you can complete that on our website, and when you click submit, it'll automatically be rerouted to us via email, and then Steve can follow up with you and or set aside your information in one of the specific volunteer groups so that when we need assistance at the office or support, he can certainly reach out to you with that. Steve, how do our viewers today reach out to us and contact us with any questions, you know, comments, concerns, or even to make an appointment?
There's several ways, and the one we just pretty much mentioned was that intake form, because it there's a section on there that it spells out what branch of service, what kind of questions that you have. That's one. There's also our phone number, 610-378-5601. You can click that, and then there's prompts to get to the right individuals. Mm-hmm. Even though you may get to myself and need someone else, we'll redirect that person to get the right help. We're located at 726 Cherry Street, right here in Reading, right across from the Santander building, and that is at this point we have free our walk-ins, eight to twelve, one to four, I believe is when the hours that you can come in and just ask.
And also, veterans can send information and inquiry through an email at veterans@countyofberks.com.
Yep.
So, Steve, I'd like to thank you so much for joining me as our new Education and Benefits Outreach Coordinator, for taking the time to introduce yourself to everyone in the community. As we end our show today, I would like to thank you all for joining us and for watching. Have a great day.